I don't know how many farmers think about their soil. A lot of meat producers think about meat, but I don't think many think about the soil.
Hi everybody, this is Gabrielle from Regeneration Canada. So in this series, we explore the world of different regenerative farmers who revitalize the health of their soil. So today we're here at Grazing Days Farm in Quebec, which specializes in an alternative kind of cattle grazing called mob grazing.
This is Grazing Days. We raise grass-fed beef and pastured pork. We try to put as many cows as possible on as small of an area as possible. So that the animals eat all the grass, they step, they poo, and they pee everywhere, and then a few hours later we move them off and the process starts all over again on a new piece of grass. The land here has been abused, and on many parts of the farm the soil is dead or pretty close to dead. And the reason we are struggling is because the farmers that have come before us on this land have focused on yield and productivity at the cost of the biological component of our soil. We are still early on in this regeneration of this land. We've been here for 4 years. Other farmers who've experienced this tell me that between 5 and 8 years is when you really start seeing this momentum build up, where this biology will start looking after the needs of the plants. Every square inch of soil is a seed bank, and there are so many dormant seeds in that soil that we as grazers and as people who are trying to regenerate the land, we need to create the ecosystem that will allow those seeds to germinate. And we will start seeing species that have not been seen in our areas for maybe half centuries, just by creating the right ecosystem. Intensive rotational grazing and mob grazing are both focused on allowing the biology to recover. It's challenging, but at the same time, it's a really good proof of concept too. If it works, then we'll be able to really showcase what we did and the challenges that we faced and really help others.
Come on.